Dear children, welcome to EVS Interactive class. Today, in the chapter Our National Heritage, we are going to discuss about paintings and dresses of India. Painting, or now we are talking about Indian painting, we know the thing since time immemorial. The earliest Indian paintings are the rock painting of prehistoric time, which are found in Bhimbetka rock shelters. Early man used to live in rock shelters, cave shelters, and he used to draw and paint there. Some of the paintings which are found in Bhimbetka are approximately 10,000 years old. You can imagine? Now, what is painting? Painting is the art of creating pictures by applying colors to the surface. Paintings can be of different type. They could be depicting about a person, place, object, about the event. They are used to tell the stories or just for the purpose of decoration of walls. When we talk about painting, how early men used to make, his techniques, his style and the things he used, they were altogether different which are used now. He used to dig up the earth, use charcoal as the basic material, the black color, minerals and colored powder to create images on the cave walls. And what early man depicted in his early paintings, they were about the hunting scene. As man was dependent on animals, he used to hunt animals for its food. Indian paintings, when we talk about different type of Indian paintings, they are broadly classified as murals, miniatures and paintings on clothes. Murals are the large works which are executed on the walls of solid structures like Ajanta caves or the Kailashnath temple. The temple is carved out of the one big rock. And miniature, as the name suggests, it's a bit smaller in size. They are small scale painting for books or albums. And some of them are found printed on materials such as paper and clothes also. Traces of murals, they are also found in the Indian rock cut architecture like Ajanta caves. And paintings were done on the cloth and they are still popular. They are used as scroll for the story by the storytellers, and we all love to wear those kind of painting on our clothes also. Paintings of India. Some popular styles of painting of India, which are actually fog painting of India. Let's know them. The fog painting, they represent real life scene and scenes from the epics like Ramayana, Mahabharat, Bhagavad Puran, as well as daily life objects like birds, animals, and natural objects like sun, moon, plants and trees, all inspired from nature and the mythology. Some of the popular Indian style paintings are Madhubani painting. It's a fog painting of Bihar. In this style, they show the scenes of Ramayana and images of Hindu gods and goddesses. The belief of public. Here you can see Madhubani painting on your left hand side, and on the right hand side is Kalamkari. Let's know about Kalamkari. Kalamkari means made by using a pen. Kalam means a pen. It's a popular art of Andhra Pradesh. We all have seen this in present day scenario also. Kalamkari saris, Kalamkari clothes. Pattachitra art. It's a fog painting of Odisha. These paintings are based on Subhadra, Bhagwan Balram, Lord Jagannath and Dashavatara. And they show the scenes of life of Lord Krishna. And they are usually using the colors red, yellow, ochre, white and black. Pithora paintings are the tribe are made by the tribes of Gujarat. It's like the ritual they used to make it. Kalighatpat art is a fog painting of West Bengal. They originated in the temple Kalighat, Kali temple of Kolkata. In this, they are showing Hindu gods and goddesses and other mythological character. Floor painting. As it's the name, it's on the floor. So this is a ceremonial painting, a traditional folk art of India. It's done in different parts of India by different name. In Uttar Pradesh, it's known as Chakpurna, Aipan in Uttarakhand, Mandana in Rajasthan, Mughalo in Andhra Pradesh, Rangoli in Maharashtra, Alpana in West Bengal, Athiya in Gujarat. For making traditionally different products, natural products are used. You can see Alpana, a kind of floor painting. It's all done with natural material, Worli yarn. It's a famous art of Maharashtra. It's made by the local tribes of Worli and it depicts the scenes from social and cultural life of the tribal people. For this, what they do, they chew the bamboo stick and use it as a brush. And as a color, they use mixture of rice paste and water gum. One important painting that show the life of Buddha, the rituals and practices of daily life, it's a Thangka paintings. These are Tibetan folk paintings. They are found in northeastern areas, especially Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh. They show the paintings of Buddha made on cotton or silk cloth. This is a Worli art painting. And this is Thangka painting that's showing Buddha, Lord Buddha. One more important type of painting is Mughal painting or miniature painting. It's a style of Indian painting as Mughals lived in India, ruled the India for centuries. During their era, their time, it took shape and it developed. They were the kings. They used to live a very royal life and they want to present themselves as the hunters and conquerors. So wherever they go for expeditions, as a military expedition or hunting, they carry their artist with them. And it depict all the, their paintings also depict the same, those kings in hunting, kings in their real life, kings in their war situation, as well as their marriages of the royal families. You can see a Mughal painting. Now we come to dresses of India. The clothes we wear, it depends on climate of the place and occasion. Here we are living in North India and most of the time it's very hot here. So what kind of clothes we wear? These are cotton clothes. But when it's the winter time, it's very harsh. At that time our clothes are different. That means it depends on climate of the place as well as the occasion. Like today, it's my friend's wedding. I'll be nicely dressed. I will be wearing something kind of lehenga, sari, a beautiful suit, isn't it? And in our daily life, we are wearing something simple, something casual. In our school, what we wear? Uniform. That means the clothes we wear depends on climate of the place and the occasion. In India, in different parts of India, we have seen women wear saris, salwar kameez, dupatta, and on special occasions, some beautiful dresses like lehengas, shararas. We have seen, you must have seen your mothers, grandmother, sister, your neighbor aunties wearing all these kind of dresses. And nowadays, in traditional, along with some modern style, what we wear? A kurta and a trouser. Men's wear. Indian traditional menswear is kurta pajama, dhoti kurta and some kind of headgear also, means that kind of turban or pagri. It's also part of Indian culture. But we spot these things not so occasionally in cities. Nowadays people are dressed up in different way. You as kids, when you go to school, you wear a uniform. It's compulsory for you to wear a uniform in school. And in your real life, you can be dressed up as any style you want. And these are the dolls which are showing a Rajasthani couple. They are dressed up in lehenga chunri. You must have seen dupatta chunri is also part of Indian dresses. And man is wearing dhoti kurta and a headgear turban. And the clothes we wear, they are made up of different fabrics, different kind. Some of them are simple cotton clothes, some are beautiful fabrics, some are silk, depending on the occasion and the climate we wear. एंड ऑन द क्लोथ्स वी फाइंड डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ पैटर्न. दे आर इंस्पायर्ड फ्रॉम फ्लावर्स, फ्रॉम लीव्स, फ्रॉम द पेंटिंग्स एंड सम स्पेशल स्टाइल ऑफ फैब्रिक एंड क्लोदिंग इज फ्रॉम डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया. यू कैन सी अ साड़ी हैज़ मधुबनी स्टाइल ऑन इट, अ कलमकारी प्रिंट एंड अ बांधनी स्टाइल ऑफ फैब्रिक. दीज आर ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ फैब्रिक्स एंड स्टाइल्स फ्रॉम डिफरेंट रीजन्स ऑफ इंडिया. हेयर ऑन द टॉप यू कैन सी ब्लॉक प्रिंटिंग, देन इज सिल्क्स, डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ सिल्क एंड द शॉल फ्रॉम कश्मीर. इंडिया इज वेरी डाइवर्स इन ऑल द वेज. दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे. आई होप यू एंजॉयड वॉचिंग द वीडियो.